Hello Python programmers, this is Eki. In this video we are going to see about how to create this 2D game using Python. This video gives an idea to you about how to create your first game in Python. After this video, surely you will get the new ideas of game development in Python. This video brings you lots of ideas and knowledge about game development in Python programming, and without wasting any time, let's start this video. Actually, I tried to build a simple game by using an arcade library in Python. Basically, this video explains about the arcade library and my simple game development experiences by using this library. First, you need to know about the arcade library. Arcade library is an easy to learn Python library for creating 2D video games. It is ideal for beginner programmers or programmers who want to create 2D games without learning a complex framework. This library helps you to get into 2D games development in Python. So this library is very simple one to create 2D games in Python, especially for beginners. And one more thing is, if you are going to try this library after watching this video, I suggest you to read the documentations and initially try to develop a simple game like this, because by using this library you can develop large games, but without understanding the basics it is very hard to develop a game in this library. Okay, so this is the reason to learn the basics first. So let's start this video with the installation part. Open your terminal and type pip3 install arcade. So next, go to your editor and import the arcade library. After importing the library, we need to create variables like screen width, screen height, screen title. In this variable, we have to give the values for screen ratios. So set the screen width as 1080 and height as 720 and title as my game. Next, we are going to design the sizes for our sprites. I think you don't know about the sprites in the arcade library. I will explain about this. The arcade library has support for sprites. A sprite is a two-dimensional image that is a part of larger graphical scene. A sprite is some kind of object in the scene that will be interacted with the game characters. So this is the definition of arcade sprites. By using the sprites, we are going to develop this game. Now we are using three major sprites in the game tutorial. Before set up the sprites, we need to give the scaling measurements to our sprites. I already said that we are using three sprites. Declare three variables like character scaling, title scaling, coin scaling, and give some amount of scaling values to the sprites. And next one is the speed attributes. We are having three sprites. Among three sprites, one is movable one and the rest of two are unmovable objects in the game. We need to give some movement speed values, gravity values and jump speed values to the movable character sprite. Okay. And after setting the values, let's come to the viewport. Viewport is very important for the 2D game development. Actually, viewport is considered as a camera angle in this game. We have to give the initial values. When the character moves in the game, the viewport value also changes along with the character. This is the main implementations in the 2D game development. Okay, so we are given some values in the previous part. The values that we are given in the previous part are constant values. It will not change if the character moves in the game. The value will be changed according to the game scenarios. And now create a class called as MyGame. This class is the main application class in the game. Under this class, we are going to create 6 functions. Each and every function has been assigned with some work. So let's start with the first function. Declare a function called as DefInit. In this function, we are going to call the parent class, and in this class, we are going to pass the screen ratio values to set up the game environment. Actually, this class holds what are the game elements that you are going to use for your game. In our game, we are going to use 4 game elements, that is coin, walls, player, exit flag. So these objects are used in our game. Now create a list for those objects. After this function, we are going to append the game character attribute values into the list. And one more thing, we need some elements that work behind the game. That are physics engine, view bottom, view left, and scores. So create these variables in this function. In order to increasing the gaming experiences, you can add some cheeky sounds. When you touches the coin, the game produces some sound effects. It will be very attractive for player who plays this game. Okay. In case of loading some sounds, we are going to use the arcade library resources for the game sound. You don't need to install these sound files in your system. It comes with the library installations. Once you see the documentation, you will understand the resources that we are using here. If you want to use that resources, just mention the path, it is enough. It will automatically merges with your game. Okay. Once you read the documentation, you will get the clarification, right? Now it's the time to set the background color for our game. So type arcade.setBackground. In this object, you have to pass the arcade.css color parameter. Next, choose the color that you want to fill in your background. Here I have chosen powder blue. It will be suitable for the most 2D game platforms. Now we successfully completed the first function. Just turn the focus on the next function, that is called as setup. Declare a function called as setup, and in this function we are going to track the screens, scores and creating sprite character list. Create a variable called as self.viewBottom and give the value as 0. And second one is self.viewLeft and give the same value as 0. These two are used to track our scrolling areas in the game. It works on the last part of the coding to change the viewport angle along with the character. I will explain about this in the last part of the video. And next, create self.score and give the value as 0. It is used to track the scores that we got in the game. After that, we are going to create the sprite list. Using this list, we are going to create the game characters, objects and their attributes. Here I created 4 sprite lists that are player list, ball list, coin list, exit list. A player list is used for creating a player character and it holds the player attributes. Next one is the ball list. It is used for the creating ball objects and it holds the ball attributes in the game. Same for the rest of 2 lists, each list holds their own attributes. Now we are going to open the list of the player. In this list we are going to create a variable called as image source. And in this variable, give the image of a character that you want to play. I already said that we don't need to download any images. Instead of downloading images, we have sprites. So sprites are built-in images that comes with the library. If you want to use that, just mention the path in your code. So in the documentation, there are so many game resources are available. If you want to use that resources, just mention the path that are given in the documentation. Here I used the image of maleadventurer.png. It is my game character and the next steps are the positions of the character and the size of the character. You need to give the X and Y position values of the screen. After giving the attributes, you need to append the data into the player list. So this is the procedure for creating the character and the objects in this game. After creating the game character, we need to create a flag image sprite. Okay, create variable called as flag image and type arcade.sprite. Inside the object, pass the image path and give the positions of the images. Positions should be mentioned in X and Y directions. After giving the positions, you need to append the data into the exit list. Now we need to create the ground tiles in the game. So create a for loop. In the loop, give some values. Using these values, the ground are created in the game environment. I am giving the values as 0, 1080, 150. This is my values. And create a variable called as ball. In this variable, type the object arcade.sprite and inside the object, pass the ground images path and give the positions where the ground tile will be placed in our game. Finally, append this data into the ball list. So follow the same steps for creating coins on the ground. It is very simple to do that. Okay. And finally, create self.physicsEngine. In this variable, type physicsEngine platformer. Inside this object, pass the player sprite, ball list, and gravity. We completed the third function. And next, we need to create another function called as onDrop. In this function, we are going to draw all the characters and objects in the game environment. We have four game elements list that are ball, coin, player, exit. We need to draw this list to create characters and images in our game. So that's all about the fourth function. Now create a fifth function called as onKeyPress. In this function, we need to assign the keys to control the character in the game. Generally, we have four keys that are up, left, right, down. When the key up is pressed, the character can jump with the help of physics engine. Follow the same steps for all three keys to control the game character. And the sixth function is onKeyRelease function. When you release the keys, the character of the game comes into its original position. When the left key is released, the player comes into its zero value. And it is a constant value, it will not change anymore. Okay. So this is the syntax, and same thing for the right key also. Now we came into the last function in the game program. So create a function called as onUpdate. In this function, we are going to update all the sprite list in the program. So call self.physicsengine.update. This is used to update all the movements and logics. Next, we need to check the collisions, like if the character touches the gem, it must be removed. Okay, so this is the logic. Now let's write a code for this logic. Create a variable called as coin hit list, and in this variable you need to type arcade.check for collisions, and create a loop. This loop continuously removes the coin from the sprite list if the character touches the gem. Okay, and using this loop we are going to update the scorecard and also the sound that plays when the character touches the gem in the game. Okay, so I created this loop to do this job. Now we are in the final stage of making this coding part. First, declare a variable called as changed and give the value as false. And create another variable called as left boundary. In this variable, you need to give the self.viewLeft that is added with left viewport margin. If a character moves towards the left boundary value is decremented from the player's right. Okay. When the player touches the end of the left boundary value, it is decremented and viewport will be automatically moved towards the right hand side. The viewport angling part of this video is a little bit complicated to understand. If you are a beginner, once you practice this code, you will get into the clarification. Okay. So same steps needed to follow for the all the keys, right, top, bottom. Okay. And if the values are changed, the viewport will change its own positions. Once you see this code, you will understand everything. Now create a function called as defMain. Under this function, call the main class that we created and set up the function that we declared previously. And give arcade.run. This is used to run this game. So that's all about the code. Now run this program. You can see that our game works perfectly. So that's all about this video. If you like this video, give a like and subscribe and share for more interesting scripts in Python. Thanks for watching and thank you. See you on next video.